Hello! Estou muito contente de estar aqui com você de novo para estudar mais um pouquinho de inglês com uma pronúncia bem britânica, um inglês bem bonito, aquele que é um cartão de visitas. Hoje nós estamos partindo para a lição 29. Lesson 29. Vou colocar no quadro. Lesson 29. Here. Lesson 29. Nine, the 29th lesson. É uma lição gostosa, fácil. Você vai ver no vídeo do Follow Me.
I want to change some money, please.
How much money, sir?
Well, I've got £150. I'd like 100 German marks and a few French francs.
How many?
Just a few, about 50. And I need a little Swiss money, too.
How much?
Hello. Good afternoon, Mrs. Taylor. Mr. Taylor, where are you going on holiday this year? You usually go to Bournemouth.
And it usually rains. This year we want some sunshine.
Yes, we're going to France. And Germany.
And Switzerland and Italy, and we need some money.
A few French francs and a few German marks.
No, Henry, we need a lot of francs and marks and Italian lira.
You need traveler's checks, Mrs. Taylor. You can change them for lira or francs or marks.
Good. We'd like some traveler's checks.
And you need tickets too. I can book your hotel for you.
I'd like to go camping.
We're not going camping, Henry. We're staying in hotels. Good hotels.
Olha só, nessa época cada país da Europa tinha sua moeda, lembra-se disso? Agora é euro para todo mundo, né? Ficou mais fácil. Ou será que nem ficou? Vamos ver no quadro algumas coisas desse trecho que você viu aí no Follow Me. Me acompanhe. Hoje você tratou de how much e how many. O vídeo tratou disso. How much e how many? São perguntas. Quanto e quantos? Se você tem uma palavra singular que não pode ser pluralizada, você pergunta how much. Mas se for uma palavra que dá para contar, então você usa how many. Vou dar alguns exemplos. Digamos, por exemplo, coffee. Café. Como é que você conta um coffee, dois coffees? Não é possível. Você vai contar uma xícara de café, tá? Um quilo de café, one cup of coffee. Então, coffee é uma palavra incontável. Quando você trata de incontável, a pergunta é how much. Então, quanto café você bebe por dia? How much coffee do you drink every day? How much coffee? Vamos ver direitinho essa pergunta. How much coffee do you drink every day? Repeat. Come on. How much coffee do you drink every day? Mais uma palavra que não pode ser plural. Veja aqui. Sugar, açúcar. Quanto açúcar você quer no seu café? How much sugar do you like in your coffee? How much sugar do you like in your coffee? Repeat. How much sugar do you like in your coffee? How much, então, para sugar? Interessante, os líquidos também, water, água. Não dá para contar uma água, você pode contar um copo de água, mas não one water, ok? Então, how much water do you drink every day? Repeat. How much water do you drink every day? Tem um que é interessante, que é money. Money. Ah, mas Marisa, money a gente conta. Aliás, sempre falta no final do mês. Money, money não se conta. Conta-se dólar, reais, libras, euros. Money não. Então vamos lá. How much money do you have? Repeat. How much money do you have? Very good. As palavras que têm plural, você usa how many. Então, canetas, mesas, amigos, how many? How many friends do you have? How many pens do you have? Ok? Mas how much money do you have? Ok? Vamos continuando com mais um trechinho do Follow Me.
I got a cold.
I know. But you've got some tissues.
I've not got many. This box is empty.
Here's another box.
There are only a few in this box. I need more.
More? We bought 5 boxes yesterday.
I had a lot of tissues yesterday. I had a lot of tissues yesterday. I've not got many now. I've not got many now. There are only a few in this box. I need more tissues. I need more tissues. Achoo! I'm cold and I'm wet.
Oh. Here's a towel.
That's your towel. Where's mine?
There's only one towel, I'm afraid.
Oh.
But we've got a lot of clothes here.
You've got a lot of clothes. Only a few of these are mine. And what's this?
Oh. It's a tent. We brought another tent. We brought 2 tents.
2?
Oh! E aí, você é fã de um acampamentozinho? Me conta. Vamos para o quadro. Já deixei tudo anotado aqui para você. Veja. I've got a cold. I've got a cold. Eles disseram lá no seu VT. I've got a cold. Repeat. I've got a cold. Good. O que quer dizer? Eu tenho um resfriado. Eu estou resfriado. I haven't got. Eu não tenho. I haven't got many tissues now. Tissues são lencinhos de papel. I haven't got many tissues now. Olha que uso de many com tissues, porque dá para contar os lenços de papel. I haven't got many tissues now. Repeat. I haven't got many tissues now. Very good. I'm cold. Estou com frio. É diferente I'm cold de I've got a cold. I've got a cold, eu estou com um resfriado. I'm cold, eu estou com frio. I am cold. And I'm wet, e estou molhado. I'm cold and I'm wet. Repeat. I'm cold and I'm wet. Good. You've got a lot of clothes. Você tem muitas roupas. You've got a lot of. A lot of quer dizer muitas. É a mesma coisa que many. You've got a lot of clothes. Repeat. You've got a lot of clothes. Clothes. Ok. Only a few of those are mine. A few of those. Poucas destas. Algumas dessas. Few quer dizer pouco. Only a few of those are mine. Repeat. Only a few of those are mine. E a última frase. We've brought 2 tents. Tents são tendas, são, como fala, cabanas de acampar, barracas. We've got, we've brought, nós trouxemos, we have brought. Two tents. Repeat. We've brought two tents. Very good. Esse pedaço está difícil ou está fácil? Então vamos continuar. Follow me.
How much luggage have we got?
I haven't got much, but you've got a lot. You've got three big suitcases and three small ones and these boxes.
That's not very much. And this isn't full. We can put more in here. What's that?
It's a television.
You won't need that.
Well, it's mine, and I want to take it.
Why are you taking these umbrellas?
Perhaps it'll rain.
We're having a holiday in the sun. We won't need umbrellas. Why are you taking these?
We'll need to open bottles of wine and cans of food. We'll need this can opener.
We'll eat in restaurants. Leave the can opener here.
Você notou esse objeto que ele está levando escondido dela? É um abridor de latas, a can opener. Vamos ver as frases que você aprendeu agora. Estão no quadro. How much luggage have you got? Veja aqui. Luggage, bagagem. How much luggage? Você não conta a palavra luggage. Você conta malas, suitcases, mas não conta luggage. Você não pode dizer uma luggage, duas. Então é how much? How much luggage have you got? Repeat. Come on. How much luggage have you got? Good. I haven't got much. Não tenho muita bagagem. I haven't got much. But you've got a lot. I haven't got much, but you've got a lot. Repeat. I haven't got much, but you've got a lot. Então, eu não tenho muita bagagem, mas você tem muita bagagem. Why are you taking these umbrellas? Why are you taking these umbrellas? Por que você está levando estas sombrinhas? Umbrellas são guarda-chuvas. Why are you taking these umbrellas? Repeat. Why are you taking these umbrellas? Good. Perhaps it will rain. Talvez chova. Perhaps it will rain. Perhaps it will rain. Repeat. Perhaps it will rain. Talvez chova. It will rain. Choverá. Ok? We'll need this can opener. Nós vamos precisar deste abridor de latas. We'll need this can opener. Repeat. We'll need this can opener. Very good. Vamos ver se foi bem sucedido esse acampamento, afinal de contas.
Is the coffee ready?
No, there isn't any coffee, I'm afraid. This jar is empty. And there's very little milk. There's a lot of tea. You don't like tea.
How much sugar have we got?
Not much.
Have we got any food?
Only a little. We didn't bring much food. There isn't any coffee, but there's a lot of tea. There's a lot of tea. There's not much sugar. There's not much sugar. There's only a little sugar. We need more sugar. We need more sugar. We haven't got enough. I'll go and buy some.
Would you get me more tissues too, please? I'll stay here. I'm writing a letter.
Do you need any stamps?
No, thanks. I've got enough.
Chegou a sua vez de repetir. Está no quadro. Veja só. There's very little milk. There is, existe, very little, muito pouco, leite. There is very little milk. Repeat. There's very little milk. Good. There isn't any coffee. Negativo de some. There isn't, não há, café. But there's a lot of tea. There's a lot of tea. Tem muito chá. There isn't any coffee, but there's a lot of tea. Repeat. There isn't any coffee, but there's a lot of tea. Again. There isn't any coffee, but there's a lot of tea. Good. Mais umazinha. There's not much sugar. Não tem muito açúcar. There's not much sugar. Repeat. There's not much sugar. Very good. Podemos continuar? Tem mais um trechinho do Follow Me para você. Vamos ver.
I'd like some stamps, please.
How many would you like?
4 7-piece stamps and 2 9-piece stamps, please.
4 7p and 2 9p.
What would you like, Betty?
I'd like some sherry, please.
How much? Is that enough?
Oh, no, that's too much. I don't want very much, thanks.
All right. I'll take this.
Would you like anything with it, sir?
Some water, please.
How much water, sir?
Just a little, please. That's enough.
Can I help you?
Yes, please. I want some coffee. Some milk and some sugar.
Here's half a kilo. Half a kilo of coffee.
No, that's too much. Have you got a smaller jar?
Is this small enough?
Yes. Thank you. May I have some milk?
A bottle of milk. Is one bottle enough?
Yes.
And you'd like some sugar? A small packet? This is half a kilo.
Yes, that's enough. And I need some tissues. A big box of tissues. No, would you get me 2 boxes, please?
A bottle of milk? A packet of sugar? A packet of sugar? Half a kilo of sugar. And 2 boxes of tissues.
Olha lá, você viu vários exemplos para você praticar bem essa diferença entre how much e how many. Sempre how much você usa diante de nomes incontáveis. How much sugar, how much milk, how much money. Então, repita. How much sugar do we have? Repeat. How much sugar do we have? Milk. How much milk do we have? Repeat. How much milk do we have? Good. Money. How much money do you have? Repeat. How much money do you have? Very good. Você notou também o uso de how many. How many kilos? How many cups? How many dollars? How many dollars do you have? Repeat. How many dollars do you have? How many cups of milk do you drink? Come on. How many cups of milk do you drink? How many books do you read every month? Quantos livros você lê cada mês? How many books do you read every month? Repeat. How many books do you read every month? E assim é que vai. os contáveis com how many, os incontáveis com how much. All right? E você viu também a lot of, que é muito. A few, poucos. Vamos continuar com follow me?
What's wrong?
I don't know.
Things always go wrong on our holidays. We're 80 kilometers from Dover.
Is there a garage near here?
I don't think so. What shall we do?
Look! There's a camping site. It's only 400 meters from here.
And it's full.
Oh, we need some vegetables. Have you got any peas?
A can of peas. Only one can.
No, three cans, please. And a can opener.
A can opener. We haven't got one, I'm afraid.
Good afternoon. We want to stay here.
I'm sorry. The camping site's full.
Wait a moment. We've got two tents. We've got a lot of food. Look, come and stay with us.
That's very nice. We'd like that.
But we haven't got a can opener. We need one for those cans of food.
Well, I'm afraid we haven't got one.
Oh, yes, we have. I brought one. And we need it.
That tent's too small for you.
Well, it isn't very big. But that doesn't matter.
What have you got there? Oh, a television.
Yes. He always takes it with him on holiday.
Shall I turn it on?
Yes, please.
When did we start?
4 weeks ago, Mr. Grant.
And how many commercials have we made?
I don't know. About 12.
12, yes. That's a lot. And they're bad. Why?
Things went wrong. Sometimes.
Not sometimes. Always. I don't understand. Fiasco is a wonderful drink. People will like it. They'll want to buy it because it's good. Why can't you make a good commercial about it? Last week, you went to the seaside. What happened?
Things happen to people who drink Fiasco.
It rained.
And you went to the Tower of London. What happened?
It was closed.
And Trafalgar Square?
I fell into the water.
Yes, you fell into the River Thames, too. And you took me with you. What will you do next?
Just a moment. Look.
Well, what is it?
Look. Hang gliding. Helen in a hang glider with a can of Fiasco.
No, no, something will go wrong. The hang glider will crash.
Well, it doesn't matter. We'll get another hang glider.
I'm not going up in a hang glider. It's too dangerous.
Look. What about a skateboard?
Well, yes, but...
A skateboard? Helen, on a skateboard?
Yes.
With a can of Fiasco?
Yes.
Yes, I like it. I like it.
It'll be all right, Helen. Come down this way, along here, up there, then turn and come slowly towards the camera. Stop and say...
Things happen to people who drink Fiasco.
You do next.
In this program, we learned I need more tissues. I've not got many now. There are only a few in this box. There's a lot of tea. There's not much sugar. There's only a little sugar. A bottle of milk. Good afternoon. Did you have a good holiday?
A lot of things went wrong, and it rained.
But we enjoyed our holiday, and we didn't change any traveler's checks.
No, we stayed in England, and we went camping.
Goodbye.
Olha, com isso, nós estamos terminando a nossa lição 29. E você já pode passar na próxima aula. Esteja comigo, você vai ver a lição 30. Está no meio do seu curso Follow Me. Quero estar com você aqui para a nossa próxima aula. Thank you so much. Goodbye.